A piece of wood went to a sculptor and said, "Can you make me beautiful?" The sculptor said, "I am ready. Are you ready?" The wood said, "Yes." The sculptor took out his tools and started chiseling. The wood complained, "Ah, what is this you're doing? It's so painful. Stop, stop." The sculptor said, "If you wish to be beautiful, you will need to tolerate the pain. All right, go ahead, but don't do so much in a day. Do a little every day." Now the sculptor began again. The wood kept complaining, "Enough for today. I can't bear anymore." But the sculptor continued with his work, and one day that wood became a beautiful murti, a deity, and got established in the temple. In the same way, we wish to transform ourselves. The ugliness within, we wish to transform it into holiness. We wish to become beautiful and adorned with the ornaments of virtue within us. The difficulties, the hardships are God's way of beautifying us. So rather than lamenting over these reversals, we can see in them opportunities for enhancing our detachment. It's like a child who was playing with his toys and had forgotten the mother. Now, rather than fight with the child, the mother arranged for the toy to be snatched away. When it was gone, the child remembered he is hungry, and he called out to his mother, who responded by coming there and feeding him milk. In the same way, we have forgotten our eternal mother, our eternal father, and we are playing with the trinkets, the sense objects of the world, the material entities. These reversals are the ways of nature for helping us turn away from the world to seek eternal life.